Data does not speak for itself. It can't speak for itself. Why? It's just a collection of numbers, and it has to be you who gives the data a purpose. You put those numbers in a particular context. Hey everyone, I'm Kyla from Venngage. Today, I'm going to talk about the basics of data storytelling. Before we begin, I want to talk about Venngage for a moment. If you're in need of data infographics, charts, reports, or maps templates, consider using Venngage. It offers a wide array of pre-designed and customizable templates. You can edit these online and download them in any format you prefer. To craft a data story, you need two ingredients. One is the data you're presenting, and the second is your perspective. When you think of a good story, it could be from any genre, a documentary, a thriller, a romantic comedy, it doesn't matter. At its core, a good story has a few key attributes. One of these attributes is a clear structure, a beginning, a middle, and an end. The bulk of the action happens in the middle. The beginning is where the premise is established. You learn a little bit about the background of the story and the context of the story. And of course, the end is where you see a resolution to the story. You can use this exact structure in your data storytelling. I want to share with you a really simple three-step process to craft a basic data story. At the middle of your data story is where the data is. That's where the action happens. But you didn't just arrive at these numbers. You began with a question or a reason, and that is our step number one. Communicating the purpose or the why behind your data. If you're a scientist or a researcher, this is where you communicate the hypothesis of your experiments. Without this crucial step, your audience wouldn't fully appreciate the data that you're about to present. Step number two is presenting your data. It's where the action is, and no, we're not just displaying a chart or a graph. We're actually expanding upon the meaning behind the numbers and what exactly we measured. If you're in science or research, you're expanding upon the experimental protocol, the procedure, the methods, the analysis, the stats, whatever is relevant to your data story. Step number three, which is often overlooked but is also important, is for us to clearly communicate the conclusion that we've drawn from our data analysis. Remember, people look at and understand numbers based on their own worldview. So it's important that we clearly communicate what we have inferred from our data analysis. Your conclusion reveals the insights that you have gathered from your data. When you structure your message in this way, you have just crafted a data story with a beginning, a middle, and an end. You came in strong by communicating your purpose. You then moved on to where the bulk of the action was, which is your data and all of the work you did to gather and analyze the data. And of course, you finished off with flair by communicating your conclusion. Try using Venngage for free. Don't forget to follow us on social media, and we'll see you in the next one.